Hey everyone, today we're going to run through the new requirements for STP Phase 2. Prior knowledge of STP and Microkeeper is ideal as we will just cover the main changes. We have broken this presentation down into three key areas. One being changes that Microkeeper has taken care of, two changes that will require action, and three changes in our capabilities. The bulk of the changes are just new fields required by the ATO, so we already had a lot of this data and we just needed to report it differently. So for example, INB gross is now broken down to OTE gross, overtime and bonus and commission. Prior to STP Phase 2, employers had to manually report child support payments to DHS. This is now included in STP Phase 2. Finalising staff in STP Phase 1 was a bit clunky. The payslip had to be marked as final and the employee had to be terminated in their employee profile. Now, as long as the employee is terminated in their employee profile, they will be included as a final STP submission. There's also much more validation with Phase 2. We won't go over all the different points, but you'll probably discover them as you navigate around Microkeeper. Now let's dive into the changes that will require action. A great starting point is to simulate a final STP report. To do this, go to your last pay run, select final and review data. There you will get a list of all the issues that are going to be raised. We've improved the links as well, so this should make it easy to correct these problems. So clicking on an employee username won't just link you to the employee profile. It will also take you to the exact field within the employee profile that needs fixing. A new field that is going to trip up pretty much every employer is the new cessation type, which is basically the employee termination reason. This new mandatory field will be required for all terminated staff going forward. For smaller accounts, this will just be a matter of updating one or two users. But for larger accounts with hundreds of staff, we've also included this field in the propagate data page and improve the filter there so you can select all terminated staff, cessation type, and then update the code accordingly. Some new income types also require a country code. For example, working holiday makers require this field. By clicking this link, we can select which country this working holiday maker is from. Next, we would recommend reviewing your shift rules and extra rules. There are lots of new allowance types. For example, car has been replaced with cents per kilometre. This helped clear up some of the terminology, but there are some new allowance types like tools and tasks, and it would be worth reviewing this list to make sure your current shift rules are in alignment with the new allowance names. Due to the complexities of Phase 2, Microkeeper will no longer support multiple income types for a single employee. So for example, if an employee switches from working holiday maker to SOAR, this employee will need to be terminated and hired again. We will include in our guide how to do this, but basically the new employee should be added and cloned from the current employee. Then the old employee can be terminated and transfer can be set as the cessation type. Okay, up next we have the new leave classification. This is probably the most administrative demanding new change to Phase 2. All these new classes have to be used under different circumstances. Paid parental, workers' comp, and defence leave are pretty self-explanatory, but other paid, cash out leave in service, and unused leave on termination will require additional admin. So unused leave on termination is pretty easy. When you click the final button for the employee, any leave will be marked as unused leave on termination. Other paid is for your other types of leave, and this is when the employee takes off normal OTE, but takes it as leave. So if they usually get paid 38 hours and they take a day off and they still get paid 38, then other paid would be the correct leave classification to select. However, if they usually get paid 38 and they're getting paid out extra hours on top of that, then that's classed as cash out leave in service. The add leave button on the payslip will use cash out while leave requests will default to other leave. If any of this is incorrect, you can always override it and select the correct option. Now we can jump to the last area, which are just some of the new capabilities. So there's a new Medicare levy surcharge and Medicare levy reduction. We won't go into the details, but they're there in the guides for those who want to read up on them. There are now 9 income types. Most of you will be familiar with SOAR, which is just a rename of the old individual non-business, IND, and working holiday maker. Most of our customers won't use any of the others, but they're there for those who need it. We have also added to the tax scale the full Medicare levy and the half Medicare levy exemptions. Whilst this isn't currently included during onboarding, this is something that could be offered to staff going forward. Most staff will be classed as full-time, part-time or casual, but for those who wish to override this field, there's now a few extra options and an explanation of these can be found in our guides. This features for the accountants out there. Many of you will use an external tax agent to submit your STP. You can now select that tax agent and they can enter their tax agent number, which means they can set up their SSID in their tax agent account. The only caveat to this is we haven't been able to test it in production yet because it can't be tested with the ATO testing facility. So we have to wait till we go live to do some production testing. Thanks for your time today. All this information will be available in our guides and also our blog area.